Morning class, welcome back to the new tutorial class. And as we were doing the chapter the French Revolution, in which we were talking about the France becomes a constitutional monarchy. So now the National Assembly has set up, and you will see they have drafted a constitution. So now the constitution, it began with the declarations of the right of men and citizens. So when we talk about the declarations of the right of men and the citizens, it is passed by the France National Constituent Assembly in August 1789. It is a fundamental document of the French. Right, such as the right to life, right of freedom, freedom of opinion, equality before law, it was established as the natural and inalienable rights. It means when we talk about the natural, that right that are given by God, or the God-given right, or by birth. And you can see inalienable rights never be taken or even given away as a life. You can see it can be never taken or given away. So as you can see, these right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, and equality before law, these were established as the natural, which are given by birth, and inalienable right. That is, they belong to each human being by birth, and it could not be taken away. So it was the duty of the state, okay, to protect each citizens these natural rights. So students, here you can see the articles that have been given in the declarations of the rights of men and citizen. So first it says that men are born and remain free and equal in rights. So the basic principle of the declaration was that all men are born and they will remain free and equal in rights in Article 1, in which was specified as the right of liberty, private property, the inviolability of the person, or secure them from violence, or prohibiting the violence. Then here comes the aim of every political association. Okay, if we talk about the constitution, the National Assembly, or any institution, government institution, is to preservation of the natural and this inalienable rights of man that has been given or that has been established by the constitutions. Okay, here you will see that they have to preserve the natural and inalienable rights of the citizen of France. As you can see, the liberty, the property, security, and resistance to oppression. Then they talk about the source of all sovereignty. Okay, it resides in the nation. So when we talk about the source of all the supreme power, okay, here it resides in the nation. So no group or the individual here may exercise authority that does not come from the people. So here you can see the power that lies within the people. Okay, so if is so whatever institution is running, okay, or you can see it is elected directly or indirectly by the people. So the actual power is in the hand of the people. So here you can see this liberty, it consists of the power to do whatever is not injurious to other. So when we talk about the liberty, it means that the condition in which an individual has the ability to act following his or her own will, freedom from captivity or control. For example, you can go wherever you want and you can say what you want, unless and until it should not harm or not injurious to other. So here you will see that if you talk about the liberty, it consists of the power to do whatever. Okay, So here you have the freedom to do whatever, but it should not harm, it should be not injurious to other. Even here you can see the law. So here you can see the law has the right to forbid, or the law can prohibit any actions that are injurious to society. Then you will see the law is the expressions of the general will, or you can see here the common interest or common goods for of citizens. So here all citizens, they have the right to participate in its formation personally or through their representatives. So all citizens are equal before it. So you will see that all citizens, they are equal before the law, and here they have the right to participate in the legislations directly or indirectly. So no man may be accused, arrested or detained except in case determined by the law. So here you will find that no one was arrested without a judicial order. Then you can see article 7 here. Here we have discussed. Now you will see article 11. Every citizen may speak. So here it talk about freedom of speech and expressions. So here you will see every citizen, they may speak, they may write and print freely. He must take responsibility for the abuse of such liberty in cases determined by the law. So here you can see that the special right is given to them. Here the right is the freedom of speech. And he is also responsible if he misuses these rights. Then here comes article 12 for the maintenance of the public forces and for the expenses, okay, of the administration. So a common tax is indispensable. So to run the administrations, okay, they require money or income. So to run the government institutions, the administrations, the bureau, you can see here, to maintain the army, the government need a source. So here it, the source is the taxes. A common taxes, that is indispensable. It means it is essential. So whatever being assessed here equally on, it will be assessed equally on all the citizens, depend upon its his wealth or depend upon his income. So when we talk about this property is a sacred and inviolable rights. It means this property is entitled to reverence and respect, and you will see, and it should be secure from assault or trespass. Okay. So unless a legally established public necessity require it, in that case a just compensation must be given in advance. So the state can possess the property unless and until it is necessary for the public necessity. And you will see the government or the state has to provide compensation for possessing or acquiring their properties. So students, every constitution, they have this certain principles, okay, in which they worked, or the constitution, they are laid down in certain principles. Okay, so here you saw the declarations of the rights of man and citizens, which was set by the National Assembly. So here you can see some political symbols. Okay, some symbols have been used and it has political significance and it has a proper meaning also. So here the topic is reading the political symbols. So the majority of men and the women, okay, who are not able to read and write, who could not read and write in the 18th century during the French Revolution. So here you can see these images and symbols, they were frequently used on printed words to communicate important ideas. Okay, so these symbols and these images, they have a meaning and important ideas. So who are not able to read and right taken, they could easily understand while seeing this symbol. So the painting here by Le Barbier uses many such symbols to convey the content of the declarations of the right. Okay, so let us try to read these symbols. So here you will see the first symbol is the broken chain. So the broken chain, they were used to fetter the slaves. So a chain, or you can see a manacles, used to restrain a prisoner. So here you can see chain were used to fetter the slave. So here a broken chain, this chain, it stand for the act of becoming free. Then here the another symbol you can see is the bundle of the rod of fascists. Okay, one rod can be easily broken, but when you can see the entire bundle, but not an entire bundle as the bundle, as the rod, okay, if they are being tied, so it is not easy for them to break. So here you will see strength lies in unity. So single rods can be broke, but when you unite with different rods, okay, when you bind it, then it will be difficult to broke. So it show that unity lie when the people are united together. So another sign you can see here, the eye within a triangle. Here you can see an eye that is within the triangle radiating the light. So the all seeing eye, it stand for knowledge. Here the eye is stand for knowledge, and the rays of the sun will drive away the cloud of ignorance. So here you can see the ray of the sun, it means it's dry away the ignorances. So it deceive the lack of knowledge. So here you can see the scepter, so which is an ornament, that staff, ornament staff or ornamented staff, okay, that is carried by the rulers on ceremonial occasions as a symbol of sovereignty. So you can see in your book that this scepter is a symbol of royal power. Snake biting its tail to form a ring. Here you can see a snake biting its tail to form a ring. It's a symbol of eternity or immortality, okay, the state after death. So ring has neither you can see beginning nor end. So here you can see another sign or the symbol is the red Phrygian cap. That cap, it was worn by a slave after becoming, you can see, upon becoming free. Then comes a lady here, you can see blue, white, red, the national color of France, blue, white, red. And then he will see in this image the winged woman. She is the personifications of the law. So you can see the representation of the abstract quality in human form. So here you can see that law has been figured in a human form. Then at the end you will see here the law tablet. So the law is the same for all, and all are equal before it. So it talk about the right to equality, where the law is same for all the peoples, and this law are equal, or all are equal before it, either of it any class or any caste. So now we come to a new topic, that is the France abolish monarchy and become a republic. So as you can see here, France abolish monarchy. So what we saw till now, that National Assembly was set up, okay, National Assembly was set up, and it put control over the power, or it limit the power of monarchy. But a time comes when the monarchy it abolished. Okay, so here last topic was the constitutional monarchy, where monarchy was there as an executive, but if we talk about the power, it power was checked by the constitution, it was controlled by the constitution. Here you will see that how this monarchy it has abolished, and now France is going to the republic and becomes a republic. So student, the situation in France, if we talk about the situation in France, it continued to be tense during the following years. You can see, although Louis XVI, he had signed the constitution, but he entered into secret negotiation with the king of Prussia. So rulers of other neighboring countries, they were too were worried by the development in France and made plans to send troops to put down the event that had been taking place there since the summer of 1789. So before this could happen, this National Assembly, they voted in April 1792 to declare the war against Prussia and Austria. So thousands of volunteers, they thrust from the province to join the army. So they saw this year as a war of the people against king and aristocracies of all over Europe. So among the patriotic songs they sang was the Marseillaise, okay, composed by the poet Roget de Lisle. So it was sung for the first time by the volunteer from Marseillaise as they marched into Paris, and to go its name. So the Marseillaise is now the national anthem of France. So it seems that this was the end of the trouble of King Louis XVI and the monarchy. Thing only got worse from there when foreign monarchies, they got involved at a time when the French people were trying to assert their sovereignty. So it had already started in August 1791 when the king's brother-in-law, Holy Roman Emperor Leopold II, King Frederick William's II of Prussia, and the king brother Charles Philip's, okay, they issued the declarations. Pilnitz, declaring their intention to bring the French king in the position to consolidate the basis of a monarchical government, and they were preparing their own troops for to take action. So by April 1792, the Legislative Assembly, they declared war on Austria over territories claims, and here the French army was completely disorganized due to the revolution and they lost. So in July they issued a statement that the Austrian and the Persians, they were intended to restore the king to his full power. And Louis XVI, he entered into the secret negotiations with the king of Prussia. Okay, so ruler of other neighboring countries, they were too were worried by the development in France and made plan to send troops to suppress the event that had these revolutionaries war. Okay, it brought losses of life and property and economic difficulties. Difficulties, or you can say economic crisis. Okay, so to the people. So here when we talk about the men and the women, so you see men, they were they were fighting at the front. And when we talk about women, they have to cope with the task of earning. So they have to earn for the livelihood of their family, for the survival or to survive. Okay. And they have to take care of their families also. So last section of the populations, they were convinced that the revolution had to be carried further. As the constitution of 79 gave political rights only to richer sections of the society. So when we talk about the last sections of the society or the people, they believe that this revolutionary war, it should be carried further. As you can see, when we talk about the constitution of 1791, okay, it gave political right to the richer sections. Okay, as you can see, when we talk about the members and the electors, members of National Assembly, and we talk about the members of or the electors, they were whom? Those who can pay the high taxes, or they were the high taxpayer. Okay, so when we talk about these members, they were the high taxpayer. So as you can see, the constitution of 79, it give political rights to the richer section. So here you can see, so the political club here, okay, where you can see people used to discuss the government policies and plans, okay, their own form of actions. So the most successful of this political club, we call it the Jacobins, which got its name from the former convent of Saint Jacobs in Paris. So here you will see women, they were two, had been very active participation. They were also very active throughout the period, formed their own clubs. So you will see that how these Jacobin clubs member, they worked and how did they bring changes in the political system of France.